Now, in addition to this basic search, there's an advanced search that takes advantage of our OLEDB connectivity. This is actually going out using our OLEDB components on the server to do a search that's more SQL-like. So, for example, I have a complete number of attributes that you won't find in the regular basic search. So, for example, one of the things I can search for is, this is part of the basic search as well. It's point source, but let me just show you what it looks like here. If I can say, let's do a point source equals R, that's going to show all the random tags. See, what this is doing is building a SQL statement. It's saying when that is true, and then also let me add another. Let's add, let's say the compression deviation. Now, that's a good one because that one is not in the basic search. We'll go into, it's called the compdev. We'll say when the compression deviation, and we'll go with greater than 2. The default is 2. So these would be those things that are not using the default compression. If I go ahead and do a search now, as you can see, this has brought up just a specific set of results based on this, in this case, 2-pole search or 3-pole, 4-pole, you know, as many attributes, as many things you'd like to add to this select statement, you can go ahead and add. Now, this supports all of the classic point attributes, and we'll talk more about those point attributes in just a second. Now, the last type of search is this alias search, and I think for that, let me switch over to a different server here. I'll go ahead and cancel out and make a connection to a second server. And now let's go ahead and do a tag search here. And I'll disconnect that. I'll now in the point builder do a tag search. Now we're defaulting to this other tag system or PI system. And under the alias search, I can drill down through what is our previous asset database. And that asset database was known as the module database. So any of you who've been around for a while, you may be familiar with, you know, the existing PI servers have supported this module database for years and years. And as you can see, if I want to, I can go out and find things using that mechanism if you're still using module database. I'll go ahead and select these two and say OK. And as you can see, what I've done is I've essentially found this using the other asset database, the module database. Now, the other mechanism we could have done from within there is we could have done a search as well. We could have done a search for, oh, let's say, all those that have a temperature or an alias mask of TEM for temperature. And this is just finding those. Or, for example, let's go with concentration. And this is finding those tags that, in this case, so you can see they have concentration as the name of their alias. Still have to select them, though. And now we've added that to the list of results. Now, finally, when you're working with the tag search, you always have available to you from within these search results, you know, from the things that you found, you always have the option to look at their attributes as well as their current values. So here I found two search results. If I want to, I can choose point attributes, and I can go through and look at the attributes of those in the search results. Again, if I go back here, oh, let me just reset this and do a general search. Let's do a general search for all my tags. And now I can select those tags that I'm interested in and choose point attributes to look at their attributes.